need to get to the bridge. From there, we can use the captain's neural implants to initiate an overload of the ship's fusion engines. The explosion should damage enough systems below it to destroy the ring.
Relatively famous and
least I still have control over the comm channels.
Where is he?
I'm detecting taps throughout the ship. Sentinels, most likely. As for the monitor, he's in engineering. He must be trying to take the core offline. Even if I could get the countdown restarted, I don't know what to do.
How much firepower would you need to crack one of the engine shields?
Not much. A well-placed grenade, perhaps, but why? Okay, I'm coming with you. Chief, Sentinels! The ship was heavily damaged by the crash. Head to the cryo chamber. You should be able to get to the engine room through there. located. We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That will do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through it. First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core. Based on the current rate of decay, we should have 15 minutes to get off the ship.
We don't have much time. We should move outside and signal for evac.
Accessing schematics. There's a service lift at the top of the engine room. It leads to a Class 7 service corridor that runs along the ship's core structure. Hurry! Bohammer is coming to pick us up. Hold position here.
Cortana to Echo 419. Two Covenant Banshees are approaching on your six. Evade. Say again, evade.
I'm hit.
She's gone.
Calculating alternate escape route. Shows one longsword fighter is still docked in Launch Bay 7. If we move now, we can make it.
aboard now! What we had to do for Earth. An entire Covenant armada obliterated and the Flood. We had no choice. Halo, it's finished.